Good evening, everyone. How are we doing out there? Appreciate you guys dressing up. You look good. Well, I'm glad you're here. This is a Student Athlete Advisory Committee production, so a student athlete event put on by student athletes. So I'm so proud of what we're going to do tonight and what we're going to celebrate, but thanks for being here. My job is here is just to introduce our hosts for tonight's event. So better known as the Voices of the Coyote Sports Network, we have junior men's golfer Ryan Tees and sophomore men's tennis player Jackson Steiner. Please welcome your Yodi Awards 2016 hosts.
Well, we'd like to welcome all of you to the second annual Yodi Awards here at Kansas Wesleyan.
Yeah, we've got a lot of athletes in the house here tonight, so it's pretty much just like any other day on campus.
We've got a jam-packed show for you guys. Got plenty of awards to hand out because of all the success we have had this season in athletics, unlike Bethany's award show, which lasted about 5 minutes.
Now, for a little bit about us, as if you don't already know who we are, Ryan and I work with the Coyote Sports Network, and so we followed each of your seasons really closely and may have even called a few of your games.
We mentioned this because this right here, the second annual Yodi Awards, is being broadcast live on the Coyote Sports Network for the first time ever. If you look up here to the second level, look at everyone looking.
He didn't even say second place.
I feel powerful with the microphone up here, just like everyone can do this. But yeah, seriously, for the first time ever, we are broadcasting the Yodi Awards live right here.
So if you want to text your mom, tell her to watch you get a Yodi here tonight, she can log on to the Coyote Sports Network via the kwcoyotes.com website.
So now that we're done with our short marketing ploy, Dr. Headland would be proud. We'll move the focus to you guys, the focus of the show, the athletes of Kansas Wesleyan.
We've had a number of teams compete at the national level this season, so we begin by acknowledging our men's cross-country team, who finished second in the KCAC and earned a trip to nationals.
Kira Lenard. She competed in the NAI National Indoor Track Meet in the race walk. Let's give her a hand. And she competed at the NAI National Cheer Competition. Let's hear it for them.
For the first time since 2012, the women's soccer team made it to the national tournament after winning the KCAC tournament crown over Oklahoma Wesleyan in dominating fashion 4-0. But not only did they make it to the national tournament, they got a win right here at home and earned a trip to the final NAI national site in Orange Beach, Alabama. Let's hear it for women's soccer.
And now football. 2-9 in 2014, 10-2 in 2015. An automatic bid, or an at-large bid, excuse me, to the national tournament. A free trip to Oregon, and some of you guys, that was the first time you've ever been on a plane. And that was pretty funny experience.
A lot of screams on that plane ride. It was a little bit disturbing at some point.
But best start in school history at 6-0. Most wins in school history with 10. What a season for those guys.
It was a great season indeed, but for all athletics here at Kansas Wesleyan, and we all know that it's just the beginning because you all have so much left in you and so far yet to go. But tonight, we're going to focus on this past year and these achievements. And so, I'd like to bring up someone who makes all of this possible. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, Kansas Wesleyan University President Dr. Matt Thompson.
How great are they? My gosh, spirit and energy.
I feel bad that I have to follow them. I'm here to talk to you about